So you installed Proxmox. Proxmox is powerful, but if you want a serious virtual machine, you need the right OS. Red Hat is one of the most used enterprise distros. And today, I'll show you how to get it for free and install it in Proxmox, step by step. So why Red Hat? It runs the infrastructure of banks, cloud providers, Fortune 500s, you name it. If you want to work in IT, get into DevOps, learning Red Hat is a huge advantage. The problem? It's normally locked behind a paid subscription. But the good news, you can get it for free, completely legal. I'll show you how to claim your free license, download the ISO, and get it installed step by step. All right, so the first step in getting your free license is heading over to developersredhat.com, click Join Red Hat Developer, and enter your details. Just a login name, password, your name, and all that, and then create my account. While you do that, when that is done, you can head back to developersredhat.com, click login, enter your details. Now to get the ISO, you click Red Hat Enterprise Linux and download and save. What you also get access to is the Red Hat Hybrid Console on console.redhat.com. It's a place where you can see your licensing usage and your inventory, and you get a lot of extra functionality out of that. So check it out. But anyways, let's head on over to the Proxmox install. All right, so head on over to PVE, select the local storage, upload, select file, and then select the Red Hat ISO. And click upload. It's done. Task OK. All right, so now we're ready to create a VM. Just click Create VM. Select the PVE node. That's a Proxmox node. It needs a VM ID. 100 is good. 105 is creative. Then you have to specify a name. I'm just going to call it Red Hat Enterprise Linux 1. Next. Then you have to use an ISO from local storage, the Red Hat ISO that you just downloaded. And just do next. Defaults are good. Here's the disks. And I think around 30 gigs should be like the minimum. But I'm going to do 35 just to have some extra gigs of space. Right here, I'll just go with default KVM 64 CPU. I'll give it 2 cores. And for memory, I'm going to give it like 4 gigs. And for the network configuration, I'm just going to do the defaults. Yeah. And it pops up here. And you can go to PVE and select it. And click start. I'm in the console here, so I'm going to press arrow up and install. All right, I'm Norwegian, but I want to use English. Continue. Now you just got to configure everything here. Time and date. That's great. And now you can connect to Red Hat. So you can use an account username and password, or you can use an activation key. The easiest way is probably just using your Red Hat username and password. But if you're in an organization, often someone administers the Red Hat account and they just give you an activation key with an organization ID and the key. To find this activation key, you can go to the Red Hat console, services, inventories, and inventory. Now, you'll be here and you'll find it under system configuration, activation keys. You'll find your organization ID here and your keys here. So since I'm already there, I'm gonna just use my organization ID and one of the keys. And we'll try to just connects. Well, it's registered. Done. So let's go to the network configuration because I want to set a host name. I'm just going to call this Red Hat Enterprise Linux 1. Apply. Done. Now you can select the installation destination. I'm going to select my hard drive. Hit done. That's good. And I'm going to set up a root password. Good practice is to not allow root SSH login with a password. So of course I'm going to allow it. It's just easier. You should create another user and use sudo. Anyways, head on over to software selection. I'm not going to have a server with a graphical interface. I'm just going to do a server. I don't need the FTP server. I'm going to have headless management. And I think that's good. Done. And now we can just begin the installation. It's done. Now we can just reboot into your new Red Hat install. Isn't that magic? And we're in. You can log on with your password. Now there's one last thing we should do, and that is DNF install q emu guest agent. The q emu agent enables the Red Hat install to talk to Proxmox in order to get, and it's already installed, so that's good. The q emu guest agent enables Red Hat to talk to the Proxmox server in order to get cleaner shutdowns and snapshot availabilities and everything. I mean, in most cases, it's good to have it installed, but you have to enable it. Press OK, and it's enabled. Now to recap. You've registered with Red Hat developers and acquired free licensing for your Red Hat installs. You've downloaded the ISO, you've uploaded the ISO to Proxmox and installed your first Red Hat VM. Congratulations, we're done. And I hope to see you again soon.